Hello friends, in this lecture series we will study about the splitting of configuration, DN configurations in octahedral and tetrahedral field. So after a splitting of DN configurations, the terms are called as Mulliken terms or molecular terms. The energy terms of free ion or atom split into their irreducible terms that cannot be reduced again, but the atomic term can be reduced in the same manner as orbital, as d orbital can be split into t2g and eg in octahedral or tetrahedral field. Likewise, the terms like p, d, f, g, h, I, which we have been calculated for strong field and weak field complexes, that are atomic terms. So these atomic terms, they can further split into some other terms that are irreducible terms, like p, the irreducible term for p is t. For d, there are two terms, t2 and e. For F, there are three terms, A2, T1 and T2. For G, A1, E, T1 and T2. For H, there are the terms E, 2T1 and T2. For I term, it is A1, A2, E, T1 and T2. So these are known as Mulliken terms. So how different configurations they split into the irreducible terms that are Mulliken terms or molecular terms, that again depends upon the type of complex and the configuration. So now we will discuss about the splitting of atomic terms into molecular ion terms. So if we take an example of D1 configuration. So for D1 configuration, we have already calculated the ground state term. So ground state term for D1 configuration was, what was the ground state term? The ground state term was D, that is 2D. So ground state term for D1 configuration was D, 2D. So for T2D term, this is atomic term. This term is atomic term, and in this term, the configuration, if we talk about octahedral field, so if we talk about octahedral field, if the complex is octahedral, so six ligands are approaching a metal. So D1 configuration, the ground state term is 2D. This is atomic term. When six ligand approach the metal atom with 2D term, then what will happen? So D1 configuration in octahedral field will be like this, so that one electron is present in T2G and there is no electron in EG. So this is the ground state. This is the ground state when octahedral complex was formed. So after complex formation, the d orbital, which is degenerate d orbital, that will split into t2g and eg. And if we see, if the electron will excite, then this is the excited state of complex, octahedral complex. So in this case, the configuration will become T2G0 and EG1. So this is excited state of octahedral complex. This is the free atom. So this is free atom. This is free atom. The ground state term was 2D. When the complex was formed, that is octahedral complex, then this is the ground state, And when in case of octahedral complex, this will be the excited state. So first of all, we will discuss about this ground state term of octahedral complex. So octahedral complex ground state term is like this. This is the ground state term of octahedral complex. So we can see that in this configuration, the one electron can be arranged like this, or it may be present here. So there are three possibilities of arrangement of this single electron in this state. So three possibilities of arrangement. It means, three means triple, means triply degenerate. Triply degenerate. So this kind of state is called as T. This is T state. T stands for triply degenerate. So the irreducible term is T. So ground state term is T. And if we take the example of excited state of this particular D1 configuration, then the configuration was T2G0 and EG1. So this is the excited state. Now there are only two possibilities that this electron can be present in this EG orbital, or it may be present in this EG orbital. So there are only two possibilities. Two possibilities means double, only double possibility means doubly degenerate. So this state is doubly degenerate. So doubly degenerate means we can represent this state by E. So there are three irreducible terms. One is triply degenerate. So for triply degenerate, we represent the term by T, triply degenerate. There are three possibilities. Doubly degenerate, there are two possibilities, and another term that is irreducible term for singly degenerate is A. So its possibility is only one. So only one arrangement can be possible for A state. So irreducible representation can be the combinations of these three terms. So for D1 configuration, again we come to the D1 configuration. So in case of D1 configuration, this was the ground state term for atom. So this is atomic term. For free ion, for free metal, this is the ground state term. So after formation of complex, this was the situation. After formation of complex, the d orbital, the d1 configuration, that will split into eg and t2g. So this is the ground state and this is the excited state where the electron was present in the e. So its possibilities are three. This may be present here or here or here. So this state is triply degenerate. There are three possibilities. Here only two possibilities. This electron may be here or it may be here. So this state is e. So these are the Mulliken terms. So if D state will split with the influence of octahedral or tetrahedral field, then D can split into T and E. And the multiplicity of the term will be same because it is generating from the term having two multiplicity. So their degeneracy, their multiplicity will 2. So this term is T2. Likewise, the d orbital splits into T2g and eg. It means doubly degenerate 2, it means triply degenerate means 3. So total is 5. There are 5d orbitals and they split into e and T2 the metal atom forms octahedral and tetrahedral complex. So total degeneracy is 5. So likewise this D, it has degeneracy 5. This is capital D term because we represent term with the capital letters. So it is split into T2. T2 means 3 degeneracy and E means 2 degeneracy. So total degeneracy will remain the same. It is 5 and it is also 5. So D split into D2 and E. So this is the octahedral in octahedral field. If we see this in tetrahedral field, so in tetrahedral field, if the configuration is D1, so if D1 is the configuration, then situation was different. But the ground state term of free ion will be 2D. But after complex formation, the situation will like this, because EZ is of lower energy, E of lower energy, and T2 is of higher energy. In case of tetrahedral complex, we do not use G or U, because tetrahedral complex has no center of symmetry. But we can represent G or U in octahedral complex because octahedral complex has center of symmetry. So in case of tetrahedral complex, one electron was present in E. And when in the excited state, this electron will transfer to T2. So this is ground state and this is excited state. But in this case, we can see that there are only two possibilities, because this electron is present in E orbital. So this can be present here or it can be present here. So now the situation is different from D1 octahedral complex. Now it becomes E. Now the ground state term is E, degeneracy is 2, and here its degeneracy is 3, because it can be here, it can be here, or it can be here. So it is triply degenerate, 3 possibilities are there. So this state is T. Now we can see that in case of D1 tetrahedra, the 2D will split into 2E and 2T. So we can summarize it. We can summarize it like this. For D1 octahedra and for D1 tetrahedra. So for D1 octahedra and D1 tetrahedra, the splitting is like this. 2D will split into 2T2 and 2E. This is the ground state and this is the excited state. While in case of tetrahedral, this will be the ground state and this will be the excited state. So this is the difference. This octahedral is just opposite of that of tetrahedra. So this is the splitting pattern of D state. It depends upon the configuration. So we can also explain with the help of another example. We can take D6 configuration. So we can explain with the help of D6 configuration. D6 configuration, we will see that it is just like D1 configuration. So in case of D6 configuration, only the difference is that the state is 5D. So if the state is 5D, then in case of D6 configuration, the arrangement of electron will like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in case of D1 tetrahedra, the situation is like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they are different situations. So in this case, T2G is asymmetrically filled. Two electrons, one electron, but this is symmetrically filled. EG is symmetrically filled. So if T2G is asymmetrically filled, means this electron pair may be here or may be here or may be here. So there are again three possibilities. So this state is again T. So there are three possibilities. So this state is 5D. But in case of D1 tetrahedra, the situation is that this electron pair may be here or may be here. So only two possibilities are there. So this state is 5D. So in case of D6 octahedra, 5T will be the ground state term, and in case of D1 tetrahedra, 5E will be the ground state term. So if we see the excited state of D1 octahedra, we can see that in case of D1 octahedra, this can be the situation. In excited state, the electron from here will transfer to here. So now the situation is different, that now this becomes doubly degenerate because this is asymmetrically filled. So the two electron may be here or two electron may be here. So there is only two possibilities. There are these are the half filled electrons. So the possibility is only two. So this is state is 5e. So in case of d6 configuration, again we can see if the situation is just like d1 configuration, and we can draw the splitting of 5d orbital. 5d state will split into two state, that is 5t2 and 5e. And this situation is just like d1 configuration octahedral, because only the difference is the multiplicity. In case of d1, the t2 was in the lower side and e was on the upper side. So the splitting of d into e and t2, that depends upon the type of configuration. So if we take an example of d4 configuration, so in case of d4 configuration, again we can explain d4 configuration. So in case of d4 configuration, again the ground state term is d. The ground state term is d. So this is 5d. So again 5d, but the configuration is this. Now Eg set is asymmetrically filled. So this electron may be here or this electron may be here. So this condition is doubly degenerate condition. There are only two possibilities of arrangement of electrons if the Eg set is asymmetrically filled. So this is 5e. And in excited state, this is the free ion term, this is the octahedral complex, and this is again octahedral complex, and the electron from here will transfer to here. Now D2G is asymmetrically filled. So these two electrons may be here, or may be here. So there are three situations, three possibilities. So again this state is T, and this is 5T2. So when 5D state in D4 configuration, it splits. It splits into 5e and 5t2. So 5e is having lower energy and 5t2 is having higher energy. So this is the splitting pattern of d term.